Hello, I'm Dr. Roy Fleischman of the Metroplex Clinical Research Center and the University of Texas Southwest Medical Center in Dallas, Texas, in the United States. In July, Rheumatology published the first integrated analysis of safety across the sarilumab rheumatoid arthritis clinical development program. With approximately 9,000 patient years of exposure, we showed that the long-term safety profile of sarilumab remained stable and was consistent with that anticipated for a molecule that inhibits the interleukin-6 signaling by blocking the IL-6 receptor. We also showed that there was no indication that the incidences of specific adverse events increased over time. Here we explain a little more about our analysis and findings. Data were pooled from 8 clinical trials and their open-label extensions. This included more than 2,800 patients who received sarilumab combination treatment for up to 7 years, and with more than 470 patients who received sarilumab monotherapy for up to 3.5 years. The analysis included a broad range of patients, including but not limited to those with an inadequate response to methotrexate or those who were intolerant to or had an inadequate response to TNF inhibitors. The safety profile was consistent with that of the individual phase 3 sarilumab trials, with no unexpected safety signals. Now we will highlight some of the key results of this analysis. We evaluated safety endpoints by 6 months intervals and didn't observe any increase in the incidence rates for adverse events or laboratory assessments over time. This figure shows serious infection rates in patients who received combination therapy. These rates are similar to those observed with other biologic and targeted synthetic DMARDs. For patients receiving monotherapy, rates of serious infections were lower at 1 event per 100 patient years. Rates of opportunistic infections such as tuberculosis and herpes were less than 1 per 100 patient years. In the article, we report incident rates of thrombocytopenia and increased levels of ALT or lipids. But the next visual, we will look at neutrophil counts. Neutropenia was reported as a common adverse event. However, patients with neutropenia were no more likely to develop infections or serious infections compared with patients without neutropenia. This figure shows that the incidence of neutropenia was most common in the first 6 months of treatment and declined thereafter. Additionally, the majority of patients with neutrophil counts below 1,000 cells per cubic millimeter achieved normalized neutrophil levels following dose interruption or reduction without permanently discontinuing sarilumab. The article also describes the incidence over time of injection site reactions and major adverse cardiovascular events, but next we will look at GI events. The incidence of GI perforations was low in this patient population, which excluded patients with a history of IBD, severe diverticulitis, or previous GI perforations. Specifically, the incident rate was 0.1 per 100 patient years, and the majority of patients with perforations were also taking non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or glucocorticoids. These are both known risk factors. Finally, this figure shows the incidence of malignancy. The overall incident rate was 0.7 events per 100 patient years with combination therapy and 0.6 with monotherapy. This is similar to the general population and lower than previously reported in reference populations of patients with RA. In addition, the incidence of malignancy remained stable throughout the observation period. To date, this analysis represents the most comprehensive long-term safety report of sarilumab, either in combination with conventional synthetic DMARDs or as monotherapy in patients with active RA. Thank you for listening to this short summary of the key safety findings. Please do visit the article to view the full results.